Hey everybody, Tom Barnes, Chicago scene, the Logan Square neighborhood, and I am at Dill Pickle Co-op. What is a co-op? What's it all about? How do they run? All these great questions that I don't know the answer to, but I know the folks inside who can explain the concept of what a co-op is, especially in terms of a grocery store. That is the Chicago scene for today here at Dill Pickle Co-op in Logan Square. All right, since 2017, this mural has graced the neighborhood of Logan Square. And I'm here with David and Italia of the Dill Pickle Co-op. Right? Did I get that right?
Yep.
So yes. For people, well, first of all, thank you for taking time out of your day. And we got you in front of the mural. It's a beautiful day, so why not do this outside? But for people who don't know what a co-op is, like, what is it and what do you guys do?
Yeah, so a co-op is a specific business model that a lot of different businesses can take, but we are a community-owned grocery store. We're consumer-owned, so anyone who shops here can have the option to become a shareholder or an owner, as we call them. We have over 4,000 owners. We started out at the Logan Square Farmers Market. There was a need to be able to access all of the food that was at the farmers market 7 days a week. So a bunch of community members, over 500 owners or shareholders, got together, wanted to create this co-op and specifically carry local, environmentally friendly products that are here in the Chicago area. So that's kind of where we spread out. We're democratically owned. There isn't a CEO or one sole owner. We're owned by the community and the people who shop here. And we have a board of directors of over 9 people who are just neighborhood friendly people that come and shop at the store, and they help run the store and manage me. They get to manage me, tell me what to do, tell me what products that they want in the store, what our ends and mission are. And so, yeah, that's kind of what co-ops are. We have 7 different principles: democratically owned, concern for community is a huge principle of ours, cooperative among cooperatives,
and sustainable, organic, and some organic, you like local. Try to offer things for people that, and local to what people want in the community. You listen to people in the community. Yeah. So much so that you were talking earlier about a democratic process where you have elections. I didn't know that was a thing. Like, we were walking by one of the walls in there, and it had all the people running for election for the next round. How does that work? Is that every year, or is how does that work?
That happens every year. Each board of director is given a 3-year term, and once that term comes up for re-election, we post a bunch of positions that are open for people to run for. And you have to be an owner for at least 6 months before you can run to be on the board of directors, and you have to be active. Like, so you had to have like shopped within the store within the last year or two. We want people who are concerned for the community, have a specific want and need to fulfill a purpose with providing great food to our community right now, and really just run the store operationally.
Right, and speaking of like that local food, David, you walked me through the store, and it was a great experience. I never really had to been through a co-op before, but you guys really highlight the fact that it's local within 300 miles of the store, right?
That's correct.
It's incredible.
A lot of producers in Indiana, Wisconsin, Iowa, 300 miles. And also, you know, we focus on a lot of local businesses, you know, different products that they carry, Black-owned, Latinx-owned, women-owned businesses. The Black Bread Company, who are out of Chicago, 3 Black guys out of Southside Chicago, they're the first sliced bread company ever. Mm-hmm. Brown Sugar Bakery, Love Corkscrew.
You even have a bakery, a roaster that gives back to the Inglewood neighborhood, but it locally.
Kusana Coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah, they give proceeds back to Inglewood. Cribby Coffee is out Forest Park. They're Black owned as well. So we have, you know, we definitely want to focus on a lot of different, you know, diversity, you know, equity and inclusivity. You know, we have a charter that we just started, so that's very important for us. We've actually increased our hiring from like 20% within the past year since I've been here.
Talk about that, like just getting through the pandemic. I mean, you guys have been a part of that, and I imagine that was difficult like anywhere else. But I mean, as a co-op, is it a different difficult degree of difficulty, I should say?
Yeah, it definitely is a different degree of difficulty. We don't have the backing or even the money that's behind big corporations such as Whole Foods, Amazon, Mariano's, all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. We're literally dependent on all of the 4,000 owners who have decided to become owners here at the co-op, and the rest of the neighborhood who decides to shop here at the store. So, you know, all of our sales that we have within a week, we depend on all of that to pay our vendors, our staff, all that kind of stuff. We don't have any huge backing like all of the other stores have.
I imagine that one of the cool things, though, just from talking to employees, that you guys start in one position and kind of make your way throughout your journey of working here to other positions. We met the store manager who was starting off in one area, but because he knew stuff about the meats and about the cheeses, he kind of made his way up. And then you guys have this wonderful array of spirits offered, and some only available here, which is creates a great reputation in Chicago, right?
Very unique. Yeah. Very niche things. And one of the things we also offer the community and our owners, we have like a lot of different programs. We have Link Match, WIC. We also have a Divvy Bike Partnership. Mm-hmm. Our co-op deals comes out bi-monthly, and that highlights a lot of different, you know, products in the store. Co-op Basics is pretty much a standard price on, you know, certain products, which are kind of white label products, you know.
Right. That's like the umbrella of the co-op model, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. And that's how you guys operate in terms of with that model.
Yes.
For people who want to like know more about it, I mean, besides like what you offer in the store, but like if they want to be an owner, you can do that right in the store when you walk in?
Yeah, you can do that right in the store, or you can go to our website. We have an entire page dedicated to ownership. We also table at the Farmers Market here in Logan Square every Sunday, where people can sign up at our table or just receive more information, not only from employees, but we also have owners that volunteer at the farmers market to just talk about why the co-op is so great, why they joined, why they're owners, and why they think that the rest of the community should join.
And that's like that's your mission, like what it is to be sustainable, to use local products, to keep prices where they need to be, right? That's like some of the core principles, right?
That some of the core principles is making sure that we are basically giving an opportunity and a place for anyone in the community to buy their groceries. When I first came out here as the GM, I was told that this place was being gentrified. There wasn't a lot of places. It was a food desert. There weren't a lot of grocery stores available. People couldn't access locally produced food. And that's what we're here. We're here to feed our community and make sure that they have access to all of the items that we can provide. And we've had a community fridge where, unfortunately, it was recently vandalized. We have to get a new one, but we would have a community fridge out in front of our store that people could, who are low income or maybe out on the streets, could come and get free food and access that. We donate to a lot of different organizations, such as Food for Not Bombs. We donate about at least 100 to 200 pounds of food a week to those organizations. We try to have zero waste, where we're composting. We have our wonderful composting program.
Yeah, just being generally great neighbors for people. And as we were walking by and you were seeing all the signs in the store of all the locally produced farms or manufacturers that you guys carry, I imagine that stimulates the economy too, just because there's an avenue for those people to sell things, you know, like a farm in Michigan or up, or a dairy farm in Wisconsin or right here in Chicago. There's several Chicago things in here. So that is fantastic, right?
Yeah, our mission really is to basically sustain the local living economy that's here around us, right? I mean, that's our main goal. We want to employ people from the neighborhood, and we want to sell products from the neighborhood.
And it's super easy. Right there, you have the blue line, the Logan Square blue line stop, and around the mural here is the parking lot. So all things that are hard to come by in certain neighborhoods, you got it right here where it's really easy for people to access. Is there anything else you want people to know about what you guys do?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Like I probably mentioned before, we're kind of a pioneer, a high park co-op. started in the 1930s. They unfortunately left the market, you know, due to finances in 2008, and then we came. So we kind of feel compelled as pioneers, you know, for the Chicago co-op, you know, culture. The exciting news is we have startups that are coming. Chicago Market is coming to Uptown, Wild Onion in Rogers Park. Southside Co-op is going to be on the south side of Chicago. Prairie Co-op is going to be in Lombard, Illinois. And can't forget about Sugar Beet, which is in Oak Park.
Fantastic. Yes. And so,
we are currently the only ones in the city of Chicago.
That's great.
And best local grocer for a second year in a row, according to the Chicago Reader.
All right, so for people who want more information about what you guys do, what's the best website for them?
You can visit us on our website, dillpickle.coop, C-O-O-P, and you can find all the information about our different programs, ownership, and what we have to offer.
Fantastic. David, Italia, thank you very much for hanging out with me. It's getting a little warm in the sun, so I'll let you guys get back in. I appreciate it. That's T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com, T-Barnes at WGNTV.com if you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Otherwise, come down here, say hi to my friends, David and Italia.